First of all, I thank you, MGM Medical College, for organizing such a wonderful CME, as well as giving me this particular topic, role of team dynamics and team leader. Emergency medicine is never one-man show. It's always a team game. It can be one-man show in cardiology, it can be one-man show in internal medicine, but emergency medicine, when it comes, it's all about a team and how we perform as a team. Hence, I consider this particular topic is not only important for resuscitation, it's important to build the emergency department. So I think it's the soul of emergency medicine. Learning objectives. First, understanding the concept of team dynamics. What is the team dynamics? Second, understanding the concept of leadership. Application of concept of team dynamics and leadership in resuscitation and building an emergency department. Understanding the attributes of the leader. And lastly, I am going to share with you the secret recipe for being a leader. Okay. So, what is a team dynamics? Team dynamics are the unconscious psychological forces that influences the direction of team's behavior and performance. That directly affects the outcome and productivity of the team. So, it's very important. What is the impact of team dynamics? They can have a strong impact on how team behaves, performs, and their effects can be complex. I will tell you in a simple language. One example, suppose you have six people in your team. Two are good friends and rest are just colleagues. It can happen in both ways, positively as well as negatively. How it will happen, positively as well as negatively? Suppose that two friends become a friend of all other fours, that become one team and they will work as a team. But if they get isolate themselves, then there will be two teams in two different teams in one group. They will antagonize each other and productivity fall down. So it's very important. So the core concept is examining the forces involved and intervening constructively to make the effects of those forces positive. We have to study the forces in team dynamics and we have to intervene whenever required. So the final outcome will be always, should be always positive. So what are the core factors? One has to define the roles. Everyone should know what they are supposed to do and they should well versed with their roles. Clear and effective communication, cooperation and support among the players, trust and belief in each other, motivation and self-belief, re-evaluation, and shared goals. So how does it apply to the resuscitation team or in emergency medicine? So clear roles and responsibilities, tasks should be given clearly. So suppose you are resuscitating the patient, task should be given. So you should take care of the defibrillator. That person should know what he is supposed to do is he should know how to defibrillate, he should know what is the synchronized cardiac rhythm, he should know the role. And knowing how to do that role. And more of confidence of performing that particular task and filling the blanks. If some colleague is getting struggling, that he should fill the gaps in their aspect also. So what we should not do, unclear roles. So this may lead to repeated tasks. Team member freelancing, somebody would like to do airway also, IV lines also, then resuscitation also. So that will happen, or he can become Ravi Kant, but that will, he will miss the important vitals. So it's all about the team, just like football. You have to give proper pass to the other person. So one should not miss the important pass. Second, effective communication. Communication should be clear, concise and precise. Calm with direct eye contact. and controlled tone of voice. 80% of problem occurs due to the tone of voice. Right? So that should be, we have to maintain in team, we have to maintain that particular thing. And make sure that closed loop communication, I am going to discuss in one slide that thing, or the upcoming slide, and make sure that everyone on one pitch, no yelling and shouting. Okay, are kya kar raha hai tu? Samajhta nahi? Pagal ho gaya hai tu? This should not happen there. So what is closed loop communication? A team leader gives order, message and assign role to the team member. Team leader confirms that that particular member understood the order, and team leader listens the confirmation from the team member that task has been done before assigning another. In simple language, team leader, great task, Dr. Gopal, good, now IV is in, now give injection epinephrine 1 mg. That particular person will give one injection epinephrine, he says that I have given injection epinephrine 1 mg IV. Close communication. Open communication, अरे कोई तो एक नहीं प्रिंट दे दो, कोई तो अरे कोई तो सब, everyone is running out of taking it. So we have to give that, हाँ, this, Gopal, you should take the epinephrine, Ravi, you should take care of the defibrillator, suppose, चलो, Priyanka, you should take care of the airway. So we have to assign the particular roles and they should focus on that particular task. Cooperation and support. Teamwork is important, help out other members when required, acts for redundancy in the role. Suppose airway management ho gaya, intubation placement ho gaya. Now he is free, so you can allot second task to that person. Knowledge sharing and constructive intervention. These should things there, but we should avoid the fixation errors. What are the fixation errors? No, whatever I am doing is right, there are no other things. This is the only way to perform. This is the only way I have did in last 20 years, so I will continue to do this only. That is what a fixation error. We have to open. Suppose sometimes we are doing resuscitation. Okay. Everything is going fine. But sometimes patient don't respond. You are giving full efforts, but patient is not responding either. That time you have to open up and ask, where we have done this much? Have we missed any something? We have to review. Sometimes if you are managing anaphylaxis, you have given IM adrenaline, IV hydrocort, patient responds. Suppose the patient is not responding. We are missing something. You should take ask these things. Whether the patient taking beta blocker, somebody will ask. Okay. So we have to review this. If this patient is not responding to our routine resuscitation efforts, we have to review what we are doing and we should open to us. Everybody can give the inputs in their part. Motivation. One has to show the camaraderie, believe in other team members. There should be a mutual respect. One should acknowledge the good work. Somebody did the good intervention, yeah, fantastic, you did a fantastic job. Acknowledge this thing. That is the biggest boost. What we should not do when you are entering emergency medicine or emergency department, keep you outside. No judgmental comment. That's it. Lack of interest in others. I am the only person. Lucky I am not looking what they are doing. And again, aggressive behavior. Yeah, emergency physician should be aggressive, but aggressive in treatment, not with the colleagues. And no, there should not be any yelling or shouting. And the re-evaluation. Re-evaluation, just like I use the Singhavlokan term. After doing something, the lion walks for a few distance and you just walk and see, everything is well. We have to do that Singhavlokan type of habit in the resuscitation. So we did things, everything is okay. Again, check airway, breathing, circulation. Reassess the patient. Remember, patient condition can change. Okay, and flexibility in changing the treatment plan and revisiting the differential diagnosis is very important. Now, shared goals. Teams are likely to fail if they don't see clearly why they are doing, what they are trying to do, and why they are doing it. So these three questions can be answered by proper training. If you are, before building a team, you suppose you are building a trauma team. Everyone should well versed with the trauma protocol. You have to teach them everything about the details of the trauma. Trauma, A, B, C, D, primary survey, secondary survey, massive transfusion protocol, everything. Then only they will realize what they are doing and what are these things. So, and all team member must know what is the successful outcome is. For example, in CPR, charity first year, CPR means a successful. Okay, like that. Conclusion, team dynamics. There are in every department, there is a team dynamics, whether you spill or not. We have to be aware about the effects of team dynamics. Create an environment of trust, defined roles and shared goals, and use clear and effective communication. Now, leadership. What is the leadership? Ability to influence, motivate and enable others to contribute towards the common goal of the team. Influence, people should get influence, they should get motivated, and they should be able to contribute towards the goal. That is the role of the leadership. So in a trauma resuscitation, team leader, one person should say that I am a team leader, or you should have that. And verbally, with confident verbalization, one can look out who is a leader there. Leader communication, again, closed loop communication, I told you what is this thing. He should use a short, clear statement, less is more, concise and precise, clear orders. Think out loud. What is meant by think out loud? Yeah. So I'm doing a trauma resuscitation. Well, this patient presented in a hypotension, we have given 1 liter of fluid. Now we can't give more fluid because that may lead to coagulopathy. Now it's time to give blood. So we should give blood program. So we have given suppose 3 to 4 for blood. Now it's time to activate vasotransfusion protocol. Like this, whatever he should think. So everybody knows. Are 8 liter there, to 2 liter there, 3 liter there. This should not happen. So thinking should be loud. Give orders to a person. Invite feedback and inputs. Task distribution. That I discuss in very much this thing. What are the tasks and what is expected from each member. Avoid tasks, information overload. Bahut jyada instruction mat do. Because they know everything. That's why they are with you. Nah? So just basic instructions should be there. Situation monitoring. Always, there should be overview of the situation. Identify process and grasp the critical elements. Avoid fixation. I told you what is meant by fixation. Perform periodic review. That is important. And this has been proven that leadership and teamwork have been shown to improve quality of CPR and adherence to guidelines, hence lead to increased survival rating in hospital cardiac arrest. So what is proposed? Better leadership and teamwork will improve the survival of the patient. Second problem, improving the quality of team building and team dynamics are key factors for increasing the quality of resuscitation and survival outcomes. Okay. So what is the recommendation? Training. There should be training. Training of the leader, training of the team member, that will increase the confidence, that will decrease the stress, and that will ultimately improve the quality of patient care. Ultimately, what we are doing all these things for a quality patient care. Patients with interprofessional team with simulation. We can do simulation. So disaster, suppose disaster team you have to announce the disaster post. It's intra-departmental work. And after that particular disaster team, you should do the debriefing. Debriefing should be there after each and every resuscitation happening in emergency department. After each and every trauma resuscitation happening in emergency department. The debriefing will give you insight that will help to improve our care in future. So, true medical emergencies, polytrauma, massive myocardial infarction, acute stroke, arrested patient, anaphylaxis, they are high stakes, high complexity, high variability, high stress. Yeah, it's stressful. It's a time sensitive. Time is brain, time is limb, time can be myocardium. In heart attack, time is myocardium. In stroke, time is brain. In acute limb ischemia, time is limb. So all emergencies are time sensitive and they are unplanned. Because you don't know what you are going to do in that particular day in emergency department. A physician knows that what he is going to do. Few patients will come for a follow-up. Cardiology is going to do the angiography, angioplasty that particular day. Orthopedic, we can do some knee replacement or one trauma. But you don't know what you are going to do on that particular day. Everything is planned, so we have to be more composed and we have to show the best temperament.
So now the attributes of the leader, 10 attributes. Guiding vision. Vision should be there. Whatever we are doing, there should be vision, and that leader should have character to pursue the goals. Vision. There is a difference between vision and sight. I try to refrain, but there is one particular, I like that particular dialogue of Bhuvan from Lagan. सपने तो वही देखा करते हैं जो पूरा कर जो सपने तो वही पूरा करते हैं जो उन्हें देखा करते हैं. So like that attitude should be there. Okay. Passion. Passion बाजार में नहीं मिलता. You have to develop the passion. Love what we are doing. Automatically passion will get generated. But you have to love what you are doing. That is important. And the leader's passion for his work. Passion for a life can become a just like a lighthouse for his followers. So this is very important. Integrity. A leader should know his strength and his weakness. He should know the strength of his teams as well as weaknesses. And he should not do undue promises. He should commit the things which he can do. Honesty. Leader must be honest in personal as well as professional life. That aura should be there. Trust. Yeah. Trust means trust is everything. You have to earn the trust. A trust should be like that. Suppose a team member, if you ask somebody something to do a team member, even if you don't like, he will not know. Are inhone bola hoga to kuch soch ke hi bola hoga. That is a trust. So that trust we have to build on these things. Curiosity. Curiosity means a person should learn new techniques. Different methods to achieve particular target, taking the calculated risk. Leader has to take a risk. Okay, he has to break the rules. That's why people love leaders. Okay, dedication. Dedication should be 100%. If whatever you are doing, you have to give 100%. Dedication is always 100%. It's not 50%, 30%. It's all or none. That particular attitude will percolate in the team member and there will be better these things. And the leader do listen. They don't dictate. They listen from every team member. Okay. And based upon their feedback, they act. And charisma. Only 0.1% leader get this charisma level. Because charisma means they can influence. Followers do whatever they say like that. But that's a very rare quality and only 0.1% people will go that level. These are the attributes of leader. Now, the secret recipe. Take a control of your life. Assume responsibility who you are. Don't blame anybody. Convey a positive and dynamic attitude. Leader should be always positive. There should not be negative thing or destructiveness. A leader's force should be always constructive. Accept the blame. Something happens in department, maybe in night shift, maybe in morning shift, maybe in ambulance, you have to accept the listening. We have to accept the blame. Take a blame, everything that happens in your department, you have to take. I can't say that, I was chutti pe tha. Aisa nahi bol sakte. Yeah, I was department pe nahi tha. Yeah, he is the leader of the team and he has to take this thing. Give credit wherever is due. If somebody is doing well, he has to give credit to the team member. It's very important. Be compassionate when you review your team members' progress. Don't judgment, are you thik kaam nahi kar raha. Go, look, try to look into, be compassionate. What can be, there can be different problems in their life. Try to understand that. One has to understand that particular thing. Think great thoughts. Turn disasters into opportunities. Turn every obstacle into the best dream. Determine the real goals and strive. When you want to tell someone something important, go and tell personally. If you want to praise in front of everyone. Anand did fantastic job. Praise in front of everyone. But you are, Anand, you did a bad thing. Ask him personally, go and tell. That is very important. Recite for then listen efficiently. Encourage teamwork and participation. Empower team member. Don't just give responsibilities. If you are giving responsibility, then you have to empower that person to fulfill that particular job. There should be effective communication, emphasize on long-term outcomes, make sound and timely decisions, treat each person as an individual. Each person has a different. We are not handling robots. Two brothers can be different. So this you applied this particular technique to this person, that can't be successful in other field. So treat each and every person differently. Protect your team. टीम के पीछे छुपना नहीं है, टीम के पीछे खड़ा रहना, that is protection. Have a vision, courage and commitment. And lastly, stay rock steady in situation of challenges and controversy. Because this is a fantastic quote, I like this. Ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at the time of challenges and controversy. Be a man. Be a leader, be a true emergency leader, keep enriching and saving the lives. Amen. Thank you.